Hi there, this is Graham from Jenham's Astro. If any of you have seen a few videos on my YouTube channel, you know that I'm a big fan of this telescope, the Celestron C90, which is a 90mm Maxitov, real bargain, very versatile for imaging the moon and the planets. Tonight I'm going to try something different, I'm going to use it to see if we can resolve some double stars. So I've chosen a very famous example called the Double Double, which is Epsilon Lyrae, which is pretty well overhead in the middle of the summer, close to the very bright star Vega. So on paper, the resolution of this scope, if you look at the aperture and the focal length, the Dawes limit resolution is just over one arc second. And Epsilon Lyrae is made of a pair of stars, which if you have enough resolving power, each of them itself resolves into two stars. So four stars in all. And the separation of those two pairs is just over two arc seconds. So on paper at least, if the seeing is good, this telescope should allow us to resolve a little bit of dark sky in between the elements of Epsilon Lyrae. So how are we going to do it? So we're going to put the basic scope onto an equatorial mount. You see here that I've attached my favourite finder, which is a Telrad finder. And I've used some tape to secure it to the side of the tube because I find that's the best way of making sure the alignment stays between the finder and the main telescope. And in order to improve the image scale, we're going to use a Barlow lens. So I've chosen a 2x Barlow. And then finally, we're going to connect a digital SLR. So this is a Canon digital SLR. And we're going to just play around with some different exposures and see whether or not we can resolve the famous double double into four stars. Okay, let's give it a go. Okay, we're ready to go. One more thing, I'm going to use one of these, which is a Bartonoff mask, a diffraction mask, which is a focusing aid. The reason we're going to need this is because I know from experience that if we use this telescope and the Canon camera, the live view screen is really only any good to see bright stars. So Epsilon Lyrae is magnitude 5 and 6 approximately, and we're going to struggle to see those images on the live view screen unless the focus is good. So what we're going to do is we're going to point the scope at the bright star Vega, use the mask to achieve a fine focus on Vega, and then move the telescope to the target, to Epsilon Lyrae. Hopefully we should be able to acquire it then on the live view screen, and we'll achieve an accurate focus. Okay, so we've centralized the bright star Vega in the live view screen. This is on the in the zoom mode, and I'm going to place the Bartonoff mask in front of the objective. Okay, so that's a characteristic picture that you get when you have one of these masks over the objective. You've got a series of lines radiating out from the object. You need to use a pretty bright star like this, and then we can see what happens when we focus one side or other of what you think is the best focus position. So that's moving one side. If we go quite a way out of focus, we can actually see an image of the diffraction mask, and then coming back into focus, and out the other side, so it's quite a fine adjustment. And then at this position we're trying to make very small changes until the three main lines radiating out approximately separated at approximately equal angles, and I think that's about the best we can do. And if we remove the mask, I think that's a good focus. We'll leave that position locked in, and then we'll move the telescope onto Epsilon Lyrae. Okay, so there you have it. After a bit of moving to and fro to centralize the double star in the live view viewfinder, you can see the two components, Epsilon Lyrae 1 and Epsilon Lyrae 2, on opposite sides of the live view field. I think it's clear that you can see a little bit of dark sky,
in between each of the pairs, so that we've clearly split this into a double-double. Shows that the C90, once again, for the money, it's a bargain. Its optical performance, at least of this particular one, is very good, and it's allowing us to see what is a challenging object clearly resolved. So all that remains to do is to try and take a few exposures of this frame and then see whether we get a good still image after a few varying exposures. Okay, I'll give that a go. Okay, so this is a result after a bit of trial and error. This is an exposure taken at ISO 400 with a manual exposure of just over 1 second. And I think you can see that each of the components is as well recorded, with a bit of dark sky in between each to show you that it is clearly a double-double. So that's it, Epsilon Lyrae, job done.